Welcome to another video. I'm going to have a go at the tabby cat. It's the harder of the two pans, and really the only reason it's harder is that the eyes are significantly harder than the other one. They are, you know, they're small pieces and they are harder, but they do give amazing effect. So the rest of it I think is not too bad at all. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start on the old nose. And I have drawn out some of it already. And I have chosen my colours. So this is going to be my palette for my nose. And I just have to work out which bits I decided on what to go where. So this is probably... We'll make that the my middle bit, or should we make it the top piece? This piece, which could be the piece that runs through here, I think. So I'm going to start there. So I'm not going to start at the top because it's easier. So this is going to be the top piece. So just cut round it. Sorry, I'm getting stuff all in the way. Camera, take that off. Take it off. Just reposition it all again so it's all roughly in the right position. Got a few little stray bits on there that I'm just gonna whip off. And that goes on there. I've got my pattern underneath, obviously, and parchment paper on the top of that. And I use Bonder Web or Wonder Under, I think it's called in the USA. And I really like it. So I'm going to use this as the piece that runs around there. Just choosing where I want to go because it's got a bit of a pattern on it. No, it's just a bit in here and that. I'm just cutting it slightly bigger than what I've got left on my pattern because I want this to go over the top of the other one because it's a slightly rough fabric, so I want a nice smooth edge, and this has got a smooth edge to it. Right, so hopefully that'll go over there. Cut it a bit slim there by the looks of it. Not done a very good job there. I can just fill in a bit behind from behind though. I don't know why I managed to cut it a bit shallow on that side. Get right on one side. Whoops. Might be able to just pull it across actually. See what we can do. No. In fact, you know what? I'm going to take it off. I'm going to take all of it off. I'm just going to put it right there and draw around what's left. Cut out a whole new piece. Right, so just get it sort of similar. I don't think you won't notice anyway, don't think, she says, hoping. See how this looks. There you go, quite happy with that. Right, next bit, and just pull that off. I'm just going to have another look, see if I can find something else. Yeah, that's nice. I like that. That'll work better. Not quite so dark as the other one. Not quite so dark as that. Right, so I'm just going to take off this pinky bit first so that I don't lose it. Right, so we'll just stick that down. Won't lose that bit. And I can cut this last piece out that I've drawn around. Okay, that's what I need to cut out. This one don't want to come off. Okay. So I need the same colour coming up this side. So I think am I going to leave that on the top, or am I going to thread it underneath? It's quite a nice clean line, so I'm going to leave it on the top, I think. I'm gonna now do, it's gonna peel it up a bit because I've gone over the top of some of it. So I'm gonna do these pieces in here. And this piece in here. Yep. So I'm going to cut this all out a bit underneath. brown first. Round. Okay. And I'm gonna slot it in. No, I'm not, I'm gonna put it on top. And I'm gonna stick that down. And then I'm going to put the other piece on right on top of it. So this is it, and this is the colour that I'm going to use. Right, so I'm just going to lift it up, get a good idea of where I want it to go. So again, I'm going to do this whole area in the brown and then put everything else onto the top of it. But I'm going to draw everything else out on here as well. There we go. Stick that back down. I think that's it. So it comes around that way, and we want it on the top. Right, so now on this one, I've got this little area under here which is the same colour as that, so I'm going to have to find another couple of colours to go in there. So I need this little bit here in the same colour. Lift it, make sure I'm getting it roughly in the right place. And just use the end of my scissors just to swing it around a bit. But I'm not going to stick it down just yet. And I'm going to find... probably use this actually that I didn't use earlier, the bit at the top. Need that bit still. That goes on top of that one, which means I do really kind of need to stick it down. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually move it right off and I'm going to stick it down here. I'm going to stick it together down here if I can. These are a bit fiddly. There we go. Right, and then one more bit, where is it? There it is. And I'm going to use this. And that's going to go under there. Obviously, I haven't got it around the right way, but... try not to burn my fingers. And then hopefully, this will all come off together. I'm very careful there. Just got a little stray bit there. And then that's going to go down there. That's just a bit too hooked on the end there. I'm just going to take some of that off. There we go. Done it now, stuck it down. So I need a very pale bit running across here. And slightly darker colour running through. Pink. Yeah. So this is going to be the inner bit of those two. Right, now the bonder web's come off, so I'm just going to see if I can just place the two together down. It's a bit tricky to see. I can't really, so I'm going to do it over here and then peel it back up again, hopefully. It's come together fairly well, so I'm just going to glue it down and then peel it back up again. Whoops, sorry. Clumsy is my middle name. Alright, pull it back up again. And away we go. So I want it to come over the top of this one, but I don't really want it to come over the top of those. So let's see if we can just right. Put that bit down so that it's definitely down, not going to come off. I'm just going to try and feed that under a bit. Right. Oops. Nearly managed to stick another bit. That's it. I'm really happy with that. Not too worried about that bit there because I've got the outer colour coming across that. And I think I'm just going to use this pail that I've used before on the bit at the top. Now, have I still got that bit where I managed to lose it? Ah, here it is. So that's going to go on the top. I'll just be able to bend that round a little bit as I go. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to stop there for today. Here end of the lesson, part one. And I'm just take this down, give you a close up. So that's how it's looking right now. Bye for now.